Hello everybody, I am Baljit Dhaka from Pinnacle Coaching Center, and today we are discussing paper code 726, which is previous year question paper of SSC CGL Tier2. And in this question paper, in this presentation, we will discuss question numbers from 76 to 100. As you know, there are 100 questions in Tier2 paper. There are 2 hours time, and each question will carry 2 marks. One, if you do wrong one question, you will 0.5 mark will be deducted. So question number 76, average of the largest and smallest 3-digit number formed by 0, 2, 4 would be. So the largest would be 420 and the smallest would be 204 from this number. Because if you write 204, this would be 2-digit number, not 3-digit number. So the difference would be, because the question is asked, what is the question is asked? average of the largest and smallest 3-digit number. Largest is 420 and smallest is 204. So total would be 624 divided by 2. You can say 312 should be the average. Answer is A. Question number 77. Average of 6 number is 3.95. Average of 2 of them is 3.4. And you can say total of 6 would be 3.95. Average of 2 of them is 3.4. You can say 2 of them 3.4. While the average of other 2 is 3.85. Total would be this. Average of the remaining 2 number would be. So we have to find the average of 2. You can say this would be the total of these 2. Remaining 2, that will be equal to, it means little bit more calculation is involved in this question. Otherwise the question is easy. So what would be the value of this? 23.70, and this would be equal to 6.80, because 3.40 you can say, and this would be equal to 14.50 is the total of this, and if we 9.20 of these two number, and average would be divided by 2, that is 4.6. A should be the answer. Question number 78. Average of 8 consecutive even number is 93. Average of 8 consecutive even number, then the greatest number would be. Average of 8 consecutive number, it means 90 even number would be 93. In other words, you can say 92, 90, 88 and 86, 3, 4, and this side would be equal to 94, 96, 98 and 100. So you see, average of this would be 93, you can say, or average of this, or average of this. Now the greatest number, question is greatest number is 100. Greatest number A should be the answer. Such kind of question better would be to solve like this. Instead of, you can also write you can also use X method, but that would be better because this is common sense. Because common sense, for example, even number average of these two would be 93. Similarly, if this average of these two be this would be 93, because this would be the middle number. So in this way you can solve this question. Try one or two more example on this pattern, you will be able to become, you can become perfect in this method. It will take not much time. Question number 79. If the arithmetic mean of 3a and 4b is greater than 50, 3a plus 4b arithmetic mean is equal to greater than 50. It, in other words, 3a plus 4b is equal to 100, is equal to more than 100. A is twice of b. If you can write A is twice of b, in other words, you can write A, and in place of b you can write, for b you can write 2a, because this is twice of b. So 5a is equal to 100, greater than 100. A would be 100 by 5, that is greater than 20. Greater than 20. Question is, then the smallest possible integer value of A. Smallest, it would be always more than 20. That is, it should be at least 21. It should be at least 21. Next question, question number 80. Average of, this arithmetic mean we have to tell, average of this number we have to tell. So average would be 360 plus 390 and divided by 3. You can write this 359 and 389, because below every in denominator you can write here, and then it will be minus 1. So this equation you can write in this format. Answer should be this. C is the answer. Question number 81. Pooja wants to sell a watch at a profit of 20%. She bought it at 10% less and sold it at 30 rupees less. But still she gained 20%. The cost price of the watch is. This is very famous question of SSC CGL. Very important question. You should note down this trick to how to solve this question. I will use Pentagon in my 100 tricks concept. Test series, you must have seen this question also. So Pooja want to sell a profit, 100 rupees cost price at the rate of 20% profit. It means selling price in first case is 120, and if you want, she bought at 10% less, it means if she bought at 90 rupees, then she will gain 20% profit. It means 20% profit, that is 18 rupees profit. In other words, you can say 108 is the SP2. This is SP1, selling price 1, selling price 2. It means 12 rupees is the less selling price than CP is 100 rupees. But here if 30 rupees is less, instead of 12, if 30 rupees less, then CP would be into 30, you can say 250 would be the selling cost price. What is the question? We have used here Pentagon technique. And here we have taken 100 rupees cost price, 20% profit, then SP first case would be 120. In the second case, if the cost price is less 10%, then it would be 90, and at the rate of 20% profit, it means 80 rupees profit, total would be SP 108. The difference is 12 is less in case of SP2. If 12 is less, you can say difference is 12. Then cost price is 100. If the difference is 30, then cost price would be 250. Answer is C. Question number 82. A shopkeeper sold his good at half of the list price. Suppose list price is 100 and sold at 50 rupees and then lost 20%. If this is SP, then CP would be 100 into 100 divided by 80. This would be CP. You can say 125 divided by 2 is the CP. If he had sold on the listed price, means 100 rupees, if he had sold on 100 rupees, gain percent would have been how much? You can say 100 difference, 100 minus 125 divided by 2, you can say 200 minus 125, that is 75 by 2. 75 2 rupees the profit on 125. In other words, you can say 125 on 125 is the CP, then profit is 75. If it is 1, then 75 by 125, and if it is 100, then it would be equal to into 100. You can say the profit would be 60%. A should be the answer. Next question, question number 83. What is the question? Two type of tea costing 180 rupees per kg and 280 rupees. 180 rupees and 280 rupees. We mixed in the ratio so that mixture obtained sold at 320. 320 is the SP, then CP would be 20% profit. At 20% profit, you can say CP would be 800 by 3. So you can solve this question through allegation technique. So it would be equal to, this is 280, so the difference would be 820 283 divided by 3, sorry, 280 minus 800 divided by 3. So it would be equal to 40 by 3, because 840 minus 800, 40 by 3. And here the difference would be, you can write directly 550, and it would be equal to 260 by 3. You can cancel 3 to 3, 40 ratio 260. In other words, you can say 2 ratio 13. 2 ratio 13 should be the 2 is the quantity of A, and quantity of B should be 13. Answer is D. Next question, question number 84. A profit of 12% is made when a mobile phone is sold at P, and there is 4% loss when the mobile is sold at Q. Then Q and P is how much? Now here the question is given, profit of 12% is made. Suppose this is 100 rupees, and profit of 12% is made when mobile is sold at Q. So 12% profit, it would be 100. This is equal to 112 is equal to P. And there is a 4% loss when the mobile is sold at Q. So 4% loss, in other words, you can say 96 here SP, then this is equal to Q. Q, ratio of Q and P, ratio of Q and P, 96 and 112. 6 is to 7 should be the rest. Answer, 6 ratio 7, because it will divide by 16. Question number 85. A sells a cycle to B at a profit of 30%, and B sells it to C at a loss of 25%. If C bought the cycle for rupees P, then the cost price of it for A was how much? So this was 100 rupees. A price, A sell a cycle to B at a profit of 20%. It means 120 rupees, and B sell it to C at a loss of 25%. 25% means 30 rupees loss. In other words, 120 minus 30, 90 rupees, 90 rupees. C bought the price which is equal to P, 90 rupees is equal to P, then the cost price of it for A was, so 90 is equal to P, 100 would be equal to P by 90 into 100, because cost price of A would be equal to P by 90 into 100, you can say 10 by 9P, D should be the answer. Question number 86. A man buys a toys for 25 rupees and sell it for 30 rupees, his gain percent. See, what is this? This is extremely simple question, very simple question, and this is tier 2 question, this is real exam question. It means during solving all question, if you leave such kind of question, then it is a blunder. Then it is a blunder. So what is the message from this question is that you will find many questions very easy, and some questions you will find very, very easy, and 2, 3, 4 questions we will find little bit above difficulty level. So if you solve 2, 3, 4 that difficulty level question and invest lot of time on them, in fact you are utilizing timing of this question in that, and you, if then you leave this kind of question, then this is a crime. So better would be to leave those questions which are difficult rather than leaving such kind of question. So main wise, 25 rupees profit is 5 rupees is profit on 25, on 100 it would be equal to 20% profit. So question number 87. From 90 80 90, a population of country is increased by 20%. From 90 to 2000, population of the country increased by 20%. From 2010 to, population of the country increased by 20%. Then the overall increased population during this period would be how much? So this you can solve by successive percentage technique. You can say 20 plus 20, that is plus 4, that is 44, and 44 plus 20, that would be equal to 72.8. 72.8, C should be the answer. You should also remember, 20 plus 20 plus 20. It will give cumulative impact of a 72.8%. Now the next question, question number 88. A supply of juice lasts for 35 days. If its use is increased by 40%, the number of days would be, same amount of juice last is. How many days you can say that this juice would be last? You can say 100 per 100 consumption, 100 is consumed in 35 days. 100 is consumed in 35 days. 1 will be consumed 100 into 35 into 100, and 140 is the consumption, then it will last for lesser day. You can say 25 days. 25 days will be the answer. So what you have to think, you have to think in that direction, in such kind of question, that whether the consumption is in, when the consumption is increased, so days will be less, and how many will be less, that you can easily find from this. Question number 89. A store offers a variety of discount that ranges from 20% to 25% inclusive. If a book is discounted to a price of 270, then its greatest possible original price was. So after discount, the price is 270. In other words, you can say greatest possible original price. It means the discount is maximum. If the discount is maximum, then price would be the maximum. Original price would be maximum. In other words, you can say if the price is 75 after discount, then the original price was 100, then 100 by 75, and if it is 270, then it would be equal to 270. Means 360 should be the maximum price. It means 360 original price, 25% discount, after that it will be 270. Question number 90. If the ratio of the cost price to selling price is 10:11, the rate percentage would be. Extremely simple question. Means 10 rupees cost price, selling price is 11, it means 1 rupees profit on 10 rupees. On 100, it would be 10%. It would be 10% profit. Very simple question. You should not leave this question. If you are working on hard question and leave simple question, this is crime. Better to leave difficult question if you are filling any difficult question. So your time management and optimization score is very, very important. This is the learning process kind of question. And remember this. In one question paper, three or four variety kind of question are coming. So this is also one important observation. A boat takes half time in moving a certain distance, downstream then upstream. Downstream means x plus y, and upstream means x minus y. And taking half time means the upstream speed is, if you I multiply it by 2, then it will be equal. The equation is now balanced. In other words, you can say, 2x minus 2y, then x would be equal to 3y, and x by y 3:1. What is the question? The ratio of the speed of the boat in still water and that of current. This is still water and this is current speed. This is still water speed and this is current speed. Total is downstream and this is upstream. Upstream timing is double. So this equation is balanced in this way. Ratio is still water speed to current speed is 3:1. Still water current speed 3:1. D should be the answer. Next question, question number 92. A tank has two pipes. The first pipe can fill it in 4 hours and the second can empty it in 16 hours. A 4 hours, second is emptying in 16 hours. If two pipes be opened together at the time, then the tank will be filled. Extremely simple question. Total capacity you can take 16. 4 hour capacity, in 4 hour 16 unit are filling. In 1 hour 4 unit will be filled, and in 1 hour 16 divided by 16, 1 unit will be emptied. It means 4 minus 1, that is 3 unit is the net impact of 1 hour to fill 16 unit. It will take 16 by 3 hours. D should be the answer. Very simple question. 93, question number 93. A farmer travelled at a distance of 61 km in 9 hours. 61 km in 9 hours. He travelled partly on foot at the rate of 4 km per hour and partly on the bicycle at the rate of 9 km per hour. Distance travelled on foot would be. This kind of question you can solve by option technique. Now 16 km, 9 hours. You have to complete 9 hours. And he traveled partly on foot at the rate of 4 km per hour. 4 km per hour, 9 km per hour. You can say 9 km per hour. Now, see, if you, the distance traveled by on foot, distance traveled on foot, if we take 16, let's first take 16. 16 into 4. In 4 hour, he will travel 60 into 4, that is 64. This cannot be answer. 16 km he is traveling and he traveled 4 km per hour. It means 16 by 4, that is 4 hour he is taking. 4 hour he is taking. It means 61 minus 16, 45. 45 km he is traveling. He is traveling on bicycle and taking 9 km per hour. 9 km per hour means 5 hour he will take. So 4 hour plus 5 hour, 9 hour. Here the answer is 9. Here this is 9. So A is the answer. So A is the answer. Why A is the answer? Because 60 km is the total distance. He is traveling by foot 16 km. And 4 km per hour is the speed. It means he will take 16 by 4, that is 4 hour. Remaining distance is 45 and he is traveling 9 km per hour. It means 45 by 9, 5 hour he will take. So 4 plus 5, 9 hour. So this is, you can say equation is balanced. Answer is A. Such kind of question you can solve like this, it will be better. A man rows upstream 36 km and downstream 48 km taking 6 hour. Very simple question. Each time speed of the current would be how much? Again read this question, very simple question. Upstream 36 km and downstream 48 km taking 6 hours each time, means to cover 36 km the man is taking 6 hours. So speed is 6 km per hour. This is upstream and downstream is 48 km in 6 hours, that is 8 km per hour. Downstream or upstream, speed of current, speed of current is difference divided by 2, difference divided by 2, 2 by 2, that is 1. 1 km is the answer. Very simple question. 1 km is answer. Difference of downstream and upstream divided by 2 is current speed, and difference and upstream plus downstream sum divided by 2 is the still water speed. So you have to remember this equation always. Question number 95. On a certain principle, compound interest compounded annually for second year at 10% per annum is 132 rupees. Principal would be how much? Very simple. It means 10 rupees first year and second year would be, for example, on 100 rupees, 10 rupees first year and second year would be at the rate of 10%, 11 rupees. 11 rupees would be the interest. So 11 rupees is the interest, then sum is 100 rupees. If the interest is 1, 100 by 11. If interest is 132, sum would be 1200 rupees. 1200 rupees. Interest for the second year would be 132 rupees. Now question number 96 and 97. This is data interpretation question. Study the bar graph and answer the given question. In general, you will find in SSC data interpretation question are very easy. So in this question, ratio, what is this question? Study the bar graph and answer the given question. Mark in first term, mark in second term, subject, these are subject and these are marks. And what is the question? Ratio of the highest and the lowest marks obtained in first term among all the subjects. This is a very peculiar situation, that however the question you will find very easy, but SSC generally does not mark this. So there are very high chances that you can do the calculation wrong. You can do the calculation wrong because you will not be able to understand this. Where this is 80 or 75, if this is 80 or 75, for example, this is 80, this should be 75. So ratio highest and lowest mark obtained first term among all the subject. Highest is 100, and lowest is, this is lowest, and lowest is 70. You will find 70. So ratio would be 10 to 7. C is the answer. Question number 97. Average mark obtained by the student for all the subject in second term. All the, this is the first term and this is second term. On all the subject. So this is 80. This is again 80. This is 75. And this is, you can say 60. 60, and then you will find it. This is 65, and this should be then, this should be then 60. So this kind of mistake, there are very high chances, and this is the generally SSC asks such kind of question. So you can say you have to be careful in such kind of question, because chances are very very high if you can mark wrong, although the question is simple. Is the average answer is D. Answer is D. Question number 98. In an institution, there are 800 students. Students use different modes of transport for going to the institution and return. The given pie gram represent required data. Study the diagram carefully and answer the question. So this is the pie chart representation, and number of students are 800. Number of students who travel in public bus. Public bus, that is 54 degree. Total is 360 degree. So into 800, you can say 800. It will be 120 should be the answer. Next question, question number 99. Number of students who do not use institute bus. This institution bus, it means 360 minus 200. 144 degree divided by 360 into 800. So 320 should be the answer. Answer is D. Next question, question number 100. This is the last question of this paper. Number of students who go to institution on foot. So this is 254 plus 1872, 288, and 360 minus 288, you will find 72 degree divided by 360 into 800. 160 should be the answer. So 160 student will travel by foot. So in this way we have covered each and every question of this test number 7 to 6, or you can say the question paper of 2015. Thank you very much for watching this presentation. All the best.